100 to 102. Today FM.
Now, if you, like me, were into punk rock back in the day and you had a copy of the album Dookie and spent a couple of moments standing around the end just to hear someone singing, "I was all by myself, no one was looking, I was thinking," you will be very glad to know that I have Trey Cool on the line from Green Day celebrating the launch of their 12th studio album, Revolution Radio. Trey, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
The brand new album, this is interesting, and it's great to see you guys back in action after 4 years of an absence. How do you feel about the whole thing?
Pretty surreal, man. For the last couple of months, we've been sitting on this thing, you know, incubating it, and we knew it was damn good, and we couldn't show anybody. I'm really happy to unleash it onto the world, and now people can hear all these songs, and now we're actually getting into kind of rehearsing some of the other songs besides Bang Bang and Revolution Radio and Still Breathing. We've been playing those live a bit, but now it's kind of fun. We can kind of dig in and play some deeper cuts. It just feels really good.
Now, the big track in Ireland at the moment from Green Day is Still Breathing. That's the one we're playing, and it's one of those songs that gives you the feeling of you're losing something, but the feeling that you've gained something. That's, I think, where the lyrics are going in that. I really like that song. It brings me back to Nimrod.
Yeah, cool. It's a meaningful song, you know. It's kind of like, you know, going through things and coming out better for it on the other side.
I know that in between things, I know Mike has been taking lessons on bass. I had heard rumors that you had taken some lessons on the drums after American Idiot as well. So is that something you guys do? Have you been off taking lessons in mad different types of drums just to get the sound right? Because you sound amazing on this album.
Oh, thanks. I'm pretty much a self-taught drummer. After American Idiot, I went and spent some time in Cuba, and I was just trying to get my head around some of those Cuban rhythms and those kind of beats. And basically what is played on a set of congas and like timbales and like three different instruments, trying to duplicate that with the drum set and doing it all yourself, it's kind of hard to do. There's this guy, Jose Ilario, outside of Havana that I went and spent a couple weeks with, and it just opens doors, you know. Getting sort of practice, to get good at something, you concentrate on what you're not great at. I mean, if I went and just played like Green Day punk rock beats all day, I'm not going to improve, am I?
Yeah, it's funny with the presidential election going on at the moment, and I know that a lot of these songs are written 2 years beforehand, but with the presidential election on, a lot of my friends are saying to me, "God, I love these songs, you know, say the likes of Revolution Radio. Is that all got to do with what's going on in America at the moment? God, the lads are brilliant, aren't they?" I went, "Oh, I think that was more got to do with the Ferguson thing." I went, "But there's a certain amount of transferability in there."
Yeah, it's kind of eerie, you know, this metaphorical words that Billy wrote like 2 years ago, it sort of became more literal now.
The resonates to a certain extent because it's like history repeating itself.
Yeah, sadly.
I'd say you guys miss being on the road. I'd say you want to get back on the road very soon.
Well, yeah, we're planning on it. We've got the European tour is actually on sale, so we're definitely coming there for sure. We want to tour this a lot. In essence, it's really a punk rock show. We get this show together on a smaller stage and, you know, an intimate gatherings really of people, and then once we sort of gel that show, then we can take that show onto a bigger stage. And we could still maintain the feeling of, you know, intimacy of a small show in, say, like an arena or even a stadium.
Anyway, we are sending some of our listeners over to Oslo.
I hear you got some sort of poetry contest.
Yeah, and they're doing well. In fairness, some budding lyricists here.
Well, that's strangely familiar because one time I ran a haiku writing contest for our, like, Idiot Nation, and the prize was a piece of me. So I had this knee surgery, and they removed a bit of bone, you know, and they let me keep it in a little vial. Some lucky gal, she wrote like 40 different haikus, and they were all fantastic. And so we sent her my bone.
So she's got a piece of Trey in her mantelpiece.
That's right.
That is pretty
cool.
Fusion
voodoo and stuff. Yeah. But hey, so this you don't get a piece of us, but you get a flyaway holiday or something. Isn't that true?
That's it. You get to go to Oslo in Norway, which is a pretty, pretty cool giveaway.
Yeah, it is. It's a great place to see us.
Would you like to hear one of them?
I would love to.
Well, here we go. This is one. This came in from Grace Lambert. She's in Glasnevin. She said, "That I get to shimmy along to Green Day live once again, or maybe it's the Jesus of suburbia that will end my disturbia and send me into the state of rock zen. I'm no basket case, so I'll already packing the suitcase so you can see me on a holiday, because when I come around, I'm hoping I'll be crowned the person on that plane to Norway. So good riddance. See you later. I want to have the time of my life. I'm hitching a ride. This Green Day fan wants to go worldwide."
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's really good. I'd say, it was nearly perfect, but they left out King for a day.
Ah, yeah.
They could have I mean, it was just screaming for a line about being king for a day. But, you know, on Lambert, very good job.
I will make sure that I take notes before we pick our winner. And just before I let you go, Trey, you held the record as one of only two men that has climbed the Universal Globe. Does that record still exist?
I still have climbed it. I didn't know anybody else had done that.
Only one other dude, but apparently you climbed it higher, so you're still the one that holds the record. Virtual high five to you.
thanks, man.
Trey, it has been a pleasure talking to you. You're an absolute gentleman, and I wish you the best of luck on tour.
Oh, thanks. And whoever does win this poetry contest, it's nice to have some Irish scholars in the audience in biking country. So more power to you. Get your pencils out and keep writing those poems. Okay, take care.
Off the Charts with Fergal Darcy.